ओके सो व्हाट इज द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे व्हाट इज द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे व्हाट इज द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे गाइस मेक श्योर दैट यू आर ऑन म्यूट ओके प्लीज मेक श्योर यू आर ऑन म्यूट फाइन या सो द टॉपिक इज लूपिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स और कोड विथ लूप्स राइट सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस टू यू व्हाई डू यू नीड लूप्स एंड देन वी विल गेट ऑन विथ लूप्स सो इफ सपोज से फॉर एग्जांपल यू गो टू एन एटीएम ओके एंड ओके फिरासत यू आर देयर ऑनलाइन
यस सर
Yeah, Firasat. Shall we discuss?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Suppose, Firasat, you know to use ATM?
I somewhat know, sir.
You somewhat know. Okay. So, what happens is, have you ever tried using your ATM?
Yes, sir. I have tried.
Okay. So, what will happen? You, swipe your card. You insert your card. Okay. Yes. And the ATM machine will ask you for a PIN, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And if you enter wrong password, what will it say?
PIN incorrect, sir.
And it'll ask you for enter once again, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, whether in Facebook password or any password for that matter, they'll give you some amount of time, right?
Say try again,
and say especially for banking, you'll have 3 to 4 attempts. That's all, and it'll close, isn't it? So, yes. Don't you think some activity is happening again and again? Yes or no? That is, it is asking you to do something again and again. Yes or no? Correct. Until, some condition that actually, passes. So after third time, you will enter the right password and then it will not ask you once again. Isn't it? Yes or no, guys?
Yes, sir.
Everyone. Guys, don't you think so? Yes, no. So some activity is happening again and again and again. And to perform such kind of activity again and again and again, what we need is loops. Okay. Can you please put that in the chat box? What do you need? What you need is loops. Yes or no? Right, exactly. We have something called as loops, and loops are there in every programming languages. Take any programming languages for that matter. You have loops because you cannot do coding without loops. Okay. So in Java, we have how many kinds of loops? It is there in the material. It is there in the material sheet. Can you tell me how many kinds of loops are there in Java? Okay. There are 3 kinds of loops in Java. Okay. There is one more which I mean, in the current material, there is only 1, 2, 3, but there is one more which I'll be discussing later. So basically there are 4. Okay. So we'll not worry about the fourth one. Now we'll only worry about the 3 loops. Is that okay, guys? There's one more which I'll talk about later. Is that okay? Did you understand what I'm saying? Okay. So for now, we'll only discuss about the 3 kinds of loops, right? So what are they? They are for, okay. They are while and they are do while. Can you put that in the chat box? What are they? For, while and do while. Everyone put that in the chat box. Everyone must put that in the chat box. Everyone. Okay. So what are the 3 looping structures? Okay. First one is for, then while, and then do while. Okay. So let me explain this one by one to you. Right. Now, if you have a for loop, okay. For loop will actually take 3 segments. How many segments? Any loop for that matter will take 3 segments. What are those 3 segments? Okay. Tell me, guys, how many segments will it take? It will take 3 segments, right? What is the first one? First one is called as initialization. I is equal to 0. Okay. Any loop, whether it is for loop or it is while loop or it is do while loop, will take 3 segments. For I is equal to 0. First is called as initialization. Second one is called as Boolean expression or a condition. Okay. You can call it as a Boolean expression. Is that okay? I less than 10 or whatever it is, right? And then say I plus plus increment or decrement. Okay. And then you will have a open brace. Then you will have a close brace, which will indicate a block. What does an open brace and close brace indicate? Tell me. What does an open brace and close brace indicate, guys? What does it indicate? It indicates a block. So that block can contain a set of statements, isn't it? Now here I will say system.out.println and I would say Java. Okay. Now let me tell you how this works, right? How does it work? Guys, do you understand how many segments are there? Tell me in your loop, how many segments are there? 3. Okay. What are they? Initialization, Boolean expression. You're supposed to say Boolean expression. Okay. And then increment or decrement. Guys, am I audible to you? Guys, am I audible to you guys? Hello. Am I audible? Yeah. Okay. Right. Yeah. So Boolean expression and increment or decrement. By the way, what do you mean by a Boolean expression? Tell me, guys, then I'll proceed further. What do you mean by a Boolean expression? Guys, what do you mean by Boolean expression? Tell me quickly. Any expression that will result in a true or false value. Very good. Any expression, expression, yeah, correct, that will result in a true or false value is called as a Boolean expression, isn't it? Now let me tell you how for loop will work. Okay. First, the control of your for loop will enter I is equal to 0, right? No. So what is the value of I? The 0 will be stored into I. Then, okay, the control will come to this Boolean expression. It will check whether this Boolean expression is true or false. Okay. Now tell me 0 less than 10. Is it true or false? 0 less than 10. Is it true or false? Put that. Everyone must put that in the chat box. Everyone must put that in the chat box. Okay. Tell me whether it is true or false. It is true, isn't it? If it is true, what will happen? The control will enter into that for loop. Okay. Before getting into I++, it will enter into that for loop, perform the activity that is there as part of this for loop. What is the activity that will that this for loop will do? It will say print Java. It will print Java. After printing Java, what will it do? The control will now go to I++. Now, what is the I value? What is I value, guys? What is I value? I value will become 1. Okay. Now, then again, the control will go to the Boolean expression. It will check whether 1 less than 10 is true or false. Is 1 less than 10 true? Yes, it is true. If it is true, what will happen? The control of the for loop will enter into this for loop and then again print Java. After printing Java, again, it will go to the increment decrement section. It will say I++, I value will become 2. 2 less than 10 is true. If it is true, I will enter. Again, say Java. Then again, I++, I value becomes 3. 3 less than 10 is true. If it is true, I will enter into this. So this keeps happening until I value becomes 10. The moment I value becomes 10, until 10 it will be happening. The moment I value becomes 10, okay, it will come and check. Is 10 less than 10? Tell me. 10 less than 10 is false. When 10 less than 10 is false, the control will not enter into that for loop. It will come out of the for loop and perform the activity that is there after the for loop. Did you understand this, guys? How for loop will work? Okay, so by the end of this for loop, Java would have printed how many times? Tell me. How many times Java would have printed, guys? After this for loop, how many times Java would be printed? Java would be printed 10 times because it is starting from 0 to 9. Yes or no? Yes or no, guys? Did you understand this? Any doubt, tell me. Any doubt, tell me. Any doubt in this, guys, tell me. I'm waiting for you. Any doubt, please ask me. Please ask me if you have any doubts, guys. I'm waiting for you. Okay. Quickly, any doubts? Any doubts, guys? I'm waiting for you. No doubts. Pakka, guarantee, clear. I was slow, no? Yeah. Now, let me get into the next kind of for loop. Okay, sorry, next kind of loop. What is the next kind of loop? Okay, right. I is equal to 0, semicolon, okay? While, okay? While Boolean expression, I less than 10, okay? Sorry, I less than 10, okay? Open the brace and close the brace. System.out.println. Guys, in interviews, don't write SOP. It is bad. Don't write SOP, okay? I am writing it now because I don't have space here. That is the reason, right? And never ever write SOP. And even in your, don't write SOP in your code and tell me in the group that, you know, the system is not working, the program is not working. It is not SOP. It is system.out.println. Okay, no? Right. Java. And then say I++. Correct, no? Now, having said that, how does this while loop work, guys? Tell me. Simple, same as your for loop. Okay, there is no difference between your for loop and while loop. Only difference is that the three segments, that is initialization, condition checking, that is your Boolean expression, and your increment decrement are distributed in while loop, whereas in for loop, all three are placed together. That is the difference, right? So let me again explain this. I is equal to 0 will happen once. So 0 would get stored into I. Then it comes to while header. Okay, so while I less than 10, the Boolean expression would be checked. So this will result in what, guys? Tell me, what does it result in? It will result in a true or false value, isn't it? It results in a true or false value. Okay, if it is true, in my case, what is it? It is true, right? So it is true. When it is true, I will enter into that loop. Okay, after entering into the loop, I will perform the activity that is part of this, you know, block of statements, that is system.out.println Java. Java will get printed and then the control will go to I++. Okay, I value will become what? I value will become 1. After this, okay, again, it goes back to the switch, while header. Okay, again, it will check for the condition. Okay, so I less than 10 is nothing but 1 less than 10 is again true. Therefore, this is true. I will enter into that while loop. I will perform SOP, that is system.out.println. I will print Java. Again, I++. I value will become 2. Once it becomes 2, I will go and check, no, the while header. So 2 less than 10 is true. I will again enter into that while loop. Say Java, I++. So this keeps happening until I value becomes 10. the moment I value becomes 10, 10 less than 10 is false. Okay, and therefore I will come out of the while loop and then continue with the rest of the statements. By the time I come out of this while loop, Java would have printed how many times? Tell me. How many times Java would have printed? Java would have printed 10 times, right? No. So why it is 10 times? From 0 to 10, 0 to 9, isn't it, guys? From 0 to 9, it would be 10 times. Is that okay, guys? Did you understand this? Yes or no? Hello, did you understand this, guys? Everyone? Yes or no? I'm waiting for you. You can ask me doubts. Don't hesitate. Ask me doubts. Even if it is simple doubt, it is okay. Ask me now. Because today there won't be doubt sessions. Okay, no, because it is late, there won't be doubt session. So I'm waiting for you. Please ask me doubts now only. Okay. And Nityashri is asking data type for the variable. Okay. Because I'm storing integer, it is int. It is understood. No, it would be integer. I'm not writing data types and all now. Okay. No, just I'm understanding. I'm telling you the concepts. Okay. So for now, the data type of I would be integer, Nityashri. Is that okay? Because I'm storing a zero in that. No. Right. Is that okay, guys? Did you understand?
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, Bhagyashri, sir.
Bhagyashri, tell me, Bhagyashri.
Sir, while we can use for loop, so why do we use while loop, sir?
It depends upon your interest, what you like, you can actually use it. Okay, so see, basically what happens in, you know, languages, right? Okay, if you go to C language has provided tool, you know, for and while. Okay, but I'm not telling you this is the reason, but let me just tell you this, okay? Might be James Gosling, when he was designing Java, he thought, if suppose he did not give while loop, okay, no, then it would be a, you know, shortage for Java, okay? But anything that you can do using while can be actually done using for. Okay, so Richie says in his book very clearly that, you know, whether to use for or while is actually a matter of personal preference. Okay, for few people like using for, few people actually like using while. Say for example, I'll give an example for this. Okay, if you can turn your page, did you turn the page? Page number 32. You turn page yes. number 32. Yeah. So in page number 32, can you see I have given you infinite loop?
Yes.
Infinite loop. What do you mean by infinite loop?
Sir, the loop which never ends.
The loop will never end. Why the loop will never end?
Because the condition is always true.
Exactly. The condition is always true. That is why. Guys, did you understand? 1 second, Bhagyashri, be online, okay? Guys, did you understand why it is infinite loop? The condition is always true. Did you see that? Yes or no? Did you see that, guys? Hello? Did you see that? It is always true, okay? So that is basically your infinite loop, okay? Now, if you see that for loop, okay, did you see how for loop is written just by using two semicolon? Did you notice it? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that is the way you create for loop using for, and while true is the way you actually use while loop, isn't it? So which method will you prefer? Tell me. Which one do you like? Which one do you like? Bhagyashri, which one you like?
While, sir.
While. Even I'd like the while. Okay. So it depends on what you like. Okay. No, there is nothing like practical, you know, practically we have to do some code using for only, or, you know, there is no nothing like, you know, something has to be done using while. So what I have observed in my experience of writing code is that sometimes when you're writing code, automatically I feel that, you know, this while suits better for this, because, you know, and if suppose I want, you know, all the statements like, you know, segments like initialization, condition checking, increment, decrement, everything to be together. Okay. I feel that is better. Then I will make use of for, or it doesn't mean that is the only way we have to do. But if you feel that, no boss, I can do this using while, I like while, then you can actually do while. So there is nothing specific that, you know, while has to be used for specific problem, or for has to be used for specific problem as such. There is no such kind of rules or anything. Okay. But yes, the language developers have given you two different loops based whichever you like, you can basically use it. But if you ask me, Subhash, what is your choice? Then I would say, especially when it comes to infinite loops, I will make use of while loop and not for loop. Understanding, okay, but doesn't mean for loop will not work. You can definitely make use of for loop. So instead of writing while true, you can actually use for loop, and it works exactly the same way how actually while loop works.
Okay, sir.
So Dhyanesh here.
Yeah, Dhyanesh, tell me.
So can we initialize that I is equal int I is equal to zero inside the while condition, sir?
No, you can. Why not? Why you can't do? Okay, but this condition will not work. Then you have to use something else for this.
No, sir. Not there, sir. We have given I less than 10, no, sir.
Here? Huh? No, you cannot do. No, you cannot do. Here, no?
Yes, sir. No, int I less than...
No, you cannot do. You want to say int I is equal to 0, like how you have done here?
Yes, sir.
No, you cannot do. Not possible. This is only Boolean expression. That's all. You must have only Boolean expression. Only one segment can be written within your while header. That's all.
Okay, sir. But for the for loop, we can put int I is equal to 0, semicolon, I less than 10.
Yeah, I mean, you are asking me int I o is equal to zero over here.
Yes, sir. You said it's not possible in while. Can we do that for for?
No. See, here you are asking me that can you put this initialization here? You are asking me.
Sir, the first doubt has been clarified by you, sir. I am asking the second doubt. Can we do that the same for for?
Here, int I is equal to zero.
Yes, sir. Exactly.
You can
write
it. Yeah, you can have three segments in this while header, for header.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. See, understand this much. Okay. Very simple.
Okay, sir.
Guys, can you mute yourself? Anyone? There is a disturbance. Okay. See, in for loop, all the segments has to be placed together, separated with a semicolon here.
Okay, sir.
Is that okay? And while loop, you can only have a Boolean expression over here. That's all. You can have multiple segments.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Is that okay? Right.
Okay, sir.
So why don't you try it out? Put a semicolon over here and try it out.
Okay, sir.
I less than 10, I plus plus, everything you put here and try it out.
Okay, sir.
You'll definitely get an error. I mean, try all these things. Is that okay?
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah. Fine. Understood. Okay. Now.
Sir, in the real time, which one preferable? For loop or while? In the real time.
Yes, sir.
Ramdev?
Yes, sir.
No, real time both are preferable. It depends on you which you like.
Oh,
there is nothing.
Like, sometimes performance issues we are going.
No performance issues. I can write and give it to you in 500 rupees bond sheet. No performance issues. Okay, with for loop or while loop, absolutely it works the same way.
Okay, sir. Got it.
The assembly instructions generated for for and while is exactly the same.
Ma.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
Mommy.
Yeah. Pratiksha here.
Ma.
Yeah, Pratiksha, tell me.
Sir, for of semicolon is also infinite loop, right?
Only for of semicolon is infinite loop. For of semicolon, as you can see in page number 2, is infinite loop.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
What was your doubt? Guys,
that was my doubt, sir. That was my doubt.
That was there in the book only, no? That was doubt. Huh? For of semicolon.
It will print infinite statement, sir. That will I answer.
Yeah, writing for semicolon is infinite loop. Is that okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, cool. Okay. Guys, I think, did you understand the concept, guys? Hello, did you understand the concept? There is nothing much to ask doubts in this, I'm sure. Did you understand the concept, everyone? It is very simple. It is very straightforward. Yes or no? Right? Just in the system, you just make some, you know, type something and try to see changes, you'll automatically get to know. Okay, so simple, understand what you need in for loop is you need to understand, you know, that it has three segments: initialization, Boolean expression, increment or decrement. In for, it has been placed together, separated with a semicolon. Okay, and in while loop, it has been distributed. Is that okay? Is that okay? Niveta, try and see. Niveta, all those things you try and see. Okay, guys, see, I'll tell you something. When I say doubt, you know, what do you mean by doubt? Guys, do you know what do you mean by doubt? Doubt is, did you understand the concept? You're understanding it. Okay. Now, if you ask me that, sir, what will happen if I remove I is equal to zero? What will happen if I remove I plus plus? What will happen if I remove semicolon? What will happen if I remove system? Instead of system dot out dot println, if I remove system, what will happen? Guys, can't you try out all this by yourself? When I start answering all your questions about what will happen if I remove semicolon, what will happen if I remove e, what will happen if I remove dot, what will happen if I remove plus, what will happen if I remove this bracket, what will happen if I remove open bracket, what will happen if I remove open brace, what will happen if I remove close brace? Guys, do you think the course will complete? Yes or no? Are you getting, guys, what I'm trying to tell you? Okay. So when I say doubt, no. Okay. Did you understand the concept? So once you understood the concept, after the class, you know, what you do is after the class, go to the system and try out the various variants, various versions, try it out, guys. Is that okay? Concept, see, the doubt should be, see, you know what, when you're asking me doubt, I should feel, wow, what a doubt, super doubt. It should be like that. Okay, you're trying to make me compiler. What will happen if I remove double quotes? What will happen if I remove semicolon? What will happen if I remove A? What will happen if I remove I? Try it out, no? Guys, you understand what I'm saying? Yes or no? Let your doubt have a little bit of power, yeah, that I should feel like, wow, what a doubt. Is that okay? Right? Try it out all those. If I remove I is equal to zero, what happens? I plus plus, what happens? Try it out. All simple things you can try out after the session, no? Yes or no? Right. Did you understand the concept is what I'm asking? Okay, because what happens in doubt session, you'll say, sir, explain for loop once again. I don't want to explain for loop once again in the doubt session. That is why I'm asking you, did you understand? Yes or no? Yeah? Okay, cool. Now, I'll go to the next kind of loop now. Okay. The next kind of loop is that, okay, do while loop, right? What is do while loop? Okay, first is initialization, I is equal to zero. Okay, then you have the keyword do, open the brace and the close brace. Okay, and do some activity. Okay, system.out.println. Okay, say Java. Okay, and then i++ semicolon, and then we'll have while. Okay, i <10. Okay, now let me tell you the concept and tell me whether you understood the concept or not. Is that okay? I'll tell you the concept. Rest you should try yourself, right? Now the concept is like this. Listen to me carefully, right? In for and while, okay, if you want to enter into, go to page number, come back to page number 31, come to page number 31, to enter into for loop or while loop. Okay, I'm talking about for and while now. To enter into for loop and while loop, right? No, it is mandatory that you have to pass the Boolean expression as true. Agree, disagree, guys, tell me. Okay, if you want to enter into that for loop or while loop, even for one time, if you want to enter, no, then you have to pass the Boolean expression. It has to become true. Agreed or not? Agree, disagree? Tell me quickly. Agree, disagree, guys? It has to be true, isn't it? Yes or no? Everyone, I want everyone to answer this. Okay. What if, okay, now listen to me. What if I want to enter into that loop at least once without checking the condition? I want to enter into that loop at least once. Once I want to enter, okay, no? And then later I will behave like the normal while loop, okay? That is when you make use of do while, okay? So do while, it means, you know, what happens in do while? First, there is no condition checking. I will enter into that loop, okay? I will do Java at least once. Once I will do Java. Okay, no, and then okay, at least once it will print. Once guaranteed, pakka guaranteed it will print, right? No, and then what happens is that okay, then I'll check the condition, okay, and then based on the condition, I will decide whether to get into the loop or not. Is that okay, guys? Hello, is that okay? Okay, it means when you go to ATM, at least once it will show you enter the pin. Yes or no? When you go to ATM, at least once it will tell you enter the pin. At least once it will execute. It will not check condition before only whether password is correct or not. It will not check. At least once it will give you the this one, enter the pin, right? And then based on the condition, whether you entered the pin right or not, then it will decide whether to go inside the loop or not. Agree, disagree? Agree, disagree, guys? Yes or no? At least once it will show enter the pin. Okay, and based on your password, whether it was correct or not, then it will check the condition and then it will decide whether to again ask you for the password or go do some other transaction. Yes or no? Did you understand what I'm saying, guys? Hello? Yes or no? Okay, concept, did you understand? Okay, don't ask me what will happen if I remove semicolon. Don't ask me what will happen if I remove double quotes. That and all you can try yourself. Okay, did you understand the concept is what I'm asking. That is important. Do you understand the concept? Okay, no. So what will happen if I remove O from D, from do? What will happen if I remove I from while? Don't ask me that kind of questions. Okay, did you understand the concept? Okay, if you, any other doubt is there, ask me quickly, concept wise. Quickly, guys. Okay, for
sir,
and, yeah.
Can you take an example and explain, sir?
This is the example is on the screen, no?
No, sir. Like, say I is equal is 8. And like, can you explain like...
Okay, no problem. What is your name?
Shruti, sir.
Ah, very good, Shruti. Okay. You tell me why I value, Shruti, we will do it.
8, sir.
8, huh?
Yes, sir.
Cool. Okay. Super. Okay, we'll do that now. Okay, what is I value?
8.
Okay. Now do. Okay. Now what? Shall I enter into this loop?
Yes, sir.
Once I have to enter, no?
Yes, sir.
Once I have to enter, I will not check condition and all. Once I will definitely enter, yes or no? So
yes,
now,
sir.
Now what will happen? It will print Java?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, definitely it will print Java. Then what will happen?
I will become 9.
Exactly, right? Then I'll check the condition. Okay, no? Now,
okay,
I less than 10?
Yes, sir.
Now again, enter into that loop. It is true, no? I less than 10 is true, no? Enter
yes, sir.
Into that loop. Okay, then system.out.println, again Java will be printed. Okay?
Yes, okay.
Then i++, what is i++? I will become?
10.
While 10 less than 10?
No, sir.
Then it will not enter, it will continue with the rest of the statements. Okay?
Thank you. Thank
Give
you,
me
sir.
One more value for I. Shruti.
6.
11.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me what will happen. First, what will happen? It'll enter into that loop.
Yes, sir.
Will it enter?
Yes, sir.
It'll enter. Correct. No. Then what will happen? Java gets.
Java will get printed.
Then what will happen?
It'll get iterated, and the condition will become false.
And then it will continue the rest of the statements. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now what will happen?
The condition will still be false, sir.
It will print Java once, correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now one more. What will happen if I is equal to 9?
I value won't get iterated, sir.
No, tell me the output. Tell me the output. First what will happen? Navigate.
First, it'll enter into the loop and Java will get printed.
Then
I value 9 is less than 10.
Hmm.
So again, it will enter into the loop.
Hmm.
It kind of becomes infinite loop. I guess.
Try this out. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Will you try this out, guys? Everyone.
Yes, sir.
Sir, no. I want you to try this out. Will you try this out? Yeah. Everyone, write that as an assignment in your book. Try this out. Try this program. Write this out. After writing it out, say return quickly. Okay, right. So Shruti, you're there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, one second. Be online. I want to talk to you, okay? Be online. Okay, so guys, did you understand infinite loop? Okay, when I say while of true, right? What will happen? It's always true. So if suppose I say system.out.println Java, how many times Java will get printed, guys? Infinite number of times. Shall I write a program and show it to you, by the way? I'll try to show a program and show it infinite. Okay. So vi infinite dot Java. Okay. So public class infinite. Okay. And then public static void main. Okay. String args. Okay. And then what will happen? What is that I'll do, guys? Okay. I'll say while true. What will I say? Okay. System.out.println. Okay. println. Okay. Shruti. I'll say Shruti. Shruti, your spelling is right? Shruti is there, not there?
Yes, sir. It's correct.
Okay. Right. I'm compiling the code. Okay. I'm running the code now. Okay. Did you see, guys? Shruti is running continuously. Yes or no? Did you notice? Shruti is running continuously. It is not stopping. It is not stopping anywhere. It is continuously running. It looks as if it is stopped. It is not stopped. It is continuing. Continuing. Okay. Now it is stopped. Okay. So this is infinite loop. Okay. Simple thing. Fine. Okay. I'm removing this. Okay. How did you stop, sir? I pressed the Control C on my terminal, Joshua. I pressed Control C. Okay. Right. So having said that, now, Shruti, you're there online?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
shall we go to the next problem? Shall we do it, navigate it? Okay. We'll give a little bit rest to Firasat, and you help me out now. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So tell me, what is the, I have given you some sample source code. Guys, did you see page number 32? I've given you some sample source code. Okay. No. Shall we navigate through that, guys? Are you all ready? Shall we navigate through that? Hello? Shall we navigate through that? Yes, no?
Yes, ready? Sir.
Everyone, put that in the chat box. Okay? Yeah, Sunil is asking, can we put a for loop inside a while loop? Yeah, you can. Try it out. Do that and try. You can. Okay? You can put for inside while inside for, everything you can do. Okay? Yeah, try it out, Sunil. Now, okay. So tell me what will happen. What is the problem? Yeah. What is it doing actually?
Find the sum of n numbers.
Yeah. To find the sum of n numbers. What do you mean by sum of n numbers? Find the sum of n numbers means what do you mean by that? Okay. Tell me what you mean by that. Find the sum of n numbers. Suppose
to, total sum we have to find.
If n numbers is 5. Okay, we will try it out. Okay, so shall we start from first year? Shruti?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Shruti, start off. Ma. Start from the class name.
Public class, sum of numbers.
That is a class name. Okay, then?
Then public static void main.
Okay, then?
Then we are initializing sum.
Okay, sum is equal to zero. How much?
Zero.
Guys, put that in the chat box. Sum is equal to zero. Then
int n.
And int n. Okay, so we have two integer variables, isn't it? What are those two integer variables? One is sum and the other one is n. Right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is the next one?
Then system.out.println, enter the value of n.
So enter the value of n will be printed on the screen, correct? No. So it is asking the programmer to enter the value of n. Isn't it, guys? Yes or no? Everyone okay with this? Hello? Yeah. Okay. Then what happens next one?
Then we have to write the scanner class.
Okay. Okay. We wrote the scanner class for what? For taking the input through the keyboard, isn't it?
Yes, sir. For okay, variable next. N.
So what are we doing next?
We are taking the input from the keyboard.
In.nextint is a method which belongs to scanner class, which is used to take a value through the keyboard, isn't
keyboard.
It? Okay,
yes,
so
sir.
We will be waiting for the programmer to enter a value through the keyboard. So tell me what value can we enter for n? Shall we enter 5?
Yes, sir.
So if I enter 5 from the keyboard, Shruti, you don't answer. Let us see if others will answer. Okay. So guys, if I enter 5 through the keyboard, where will it go and sit? In which variable will it go and sit? Guys, tell me. Where will it go and sit? Okay. Very good. It will go and sit in n. Okay. Continue. Yeah. Continue. Shruti, continue. Ma.
Then we have a for loop, sir.
Okay.
Integer I is equal to 0.
Okay. First it will be int I is equal to 0. Okay. Then?
Then I is less than or equal to n.
Okay. So what is I value now?
I will be 0.
I will be 0. Okay. Let me write it over here. I value 0. Okay. Then is n value is what?
5, sir.
5. Okay. So is I less than or equal to n? Is 0 is less than or equal to 5?
Yes, sir.
So no, guys, I mean 0 is less than or equal to 5. Okay, so should I go to I++ or should I enter into that for loop?
You should enter into the for loop, sir.
I should not go to I++?
No, sir.
Very good. I should enter into the for loop. Then what will happen?
Then the sum gets...
initially
sum
was how much? What was
zero.
Sum value initially? It was 0. Okay, then what happens?
Now it becomes 1, sir.
How it becomes 1? Tell me that clearly.
Will it add 1...
What is sum value initially?
Sum is 0. So for that, we'll add plus 1.
0 plus I. One. What is I value? I value is 0, no? How it become 1?
Oh, I thought sum plus 1. So sorry, sir.
It is sum plus I. It is sum plus I. Yes or no? So
yes, sir.
Sum value was 0. 0 plus 0 is how much?
0.
So sum is equal to sum plus I, isn't it? So what is
yes,
sum
sir.
Value? Initially it was 0. 0 plus I is how much? 0.
0.
Okay, so 0 plus 0 is how much? 0. That will get stored into the sum. So sum value will become 0, isn't it? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then what will happen? The value, the control will go to?
I++.
Very good. The control will now go to I++. Then what will happen?
Now the value of I becomes 1.
I value will become 1. Very good. Then what will happen? I value will become 1. Okay. Then what will happen?
Then we have to check the condition.
Again, we have to check the condition, correct? Whether I is less than or equal to n, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
I value is 1. 1 less than or equal to 5.
Yes, sir.
1 less than
it's
or
true.
Equal to 5. It is true. So enter into that for loop. After entering into the for loop, what will happen? Sum is equal to sum plus I. What is sum value?
Sum is 0.
0 plus I value is how much?
1. I is 1.
So 0 plus 1
so,
is 1. So
1 gets stored in sum.
Exactly. So 1 will get stored into sum. Then what will happen? Will I go to I++ again?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So tell me.
I becomes 2.
Then?
2 is less than or equal to 5.
Okay.
Then again we'll enter into the loop.
Okay.
Then sum value becomes 2 now.
How it becomes 2? Because earlier it was 1. 1,
1?
Plus... Tell me.
Sum plus I.
What is I value?
I value is 2 and we are adding.
Okay, 1 plus 2.
Yes, sir.
So what does it become? See, it's there on the screen. What will happen then?
It becomes 3.
It becomes 3. Then?
And we'll again it I plus plus. I becomes 3 and 3 is, we have to check the condition that 3 is less than or equal to n. And again, we have to enter into the loop. And... sum is equal to sum plus I. Sum value is 3 and we have to add I to 3. I mean,
so what will happen?
Right.
Sum plus I. Sum plus I. I value is 3, no?
Yes, sir.
So sum plus 3 plus 3 is how much?
6.
Okay, now it becomes 6. Then I plus plus. I value will become?
7.
I value will become 7 now?
No, sir. 4.
Four.
We have to check the condition that 4 is less than or equal to 5.
Okay.
It's true. Then again, we'll have to enter into the loop. Sum will be 6 and we'll have to add 4 to it.
So it becomes how much?
It will become 10.
Okay, then I plus plus.
I plus plus. So I value will be 5. 5 is less than or equal to n. It's true. So we'll enter into the loop again.
Okay.
Sum value will be 10 and we are adding I value to it, which will be 15. Sum value will be 15.
So it will become 15. Okay, then.
And
we'll I value will become 6.
6. But 6 is.
Come to the Boolean expression. 6 less than or equal to 5. False.
It's false.
So therefore, I'll come out of the for loop, correct?
Yes, sir.
When I, after coming out of the for loop, there is one statement. What is that?
Sum of n.
System dot out dot println is equal to.
Sum of n. N is.
Sum of n value is what?
5
numbers.
Okay.
Is
15.
15. Tell me now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Will you get 15? Add all these. Okay. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Shruti, 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 6. 10. 10 plus 5 is 15. So we get 15 and we have got the 15. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Do you understand this now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Guys, did you all understand this? Don't go away, Shruti. Okay. Wait with me.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Guys, did you understand? Everyone? No doubt, no? There cannot be any doubt because we have navigated it completely in detail. Yes or no, guys? Hello? Yes or no? Tell me quickly. Everyone should put that in the chat box. Everyone, quickly. Okay? Is that okay? Everyone, right? Yeah, awesome. I want you to navigate like this even after the class. Navigate it like this after the class also, okay? You have to navigate and go and teach someone else. Is that okay? Right. Now, shall we start? We'll go to the next one, guys. Shall we navigate like this only? Next one also? Yeah? Okay. Tell me, ma.
The second question is to repeat the addition quiz.
We have to repeat the addition quiz, isn't it? Okay, it means if the answer is wrong, okay, you'll have to, we'll see what happens, okay? Yeah, you continue, ma. Tell me.
Class name is addition quiz.
Class name is addition quiz, okay?
Then public static void main.
Okay.
And we have int num1 is math rand.
Math.random into 10. So we will get some random number, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So let us assume that the random number that we get is 5 for the first time. Okay?
Okay,
sir.
We
get a random number. Tell me random number with what range we'll get?
We have typecasted it to integer, so it'll be from 0 to 9.
Yeah, if I wouldn't have typecasted, then I would have got it from 0.0 to 9.0, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Now it is integer because I'm getting it, therefore I'll get it from 0 to 9, isn't it?
Yes, okay. Sir.
So now tell me what is the value that I'll get now. So let me take it as 5. Shall I take it as 5? Okay. Assume that I got a value as 5. Is that okay, guys, everyone? Num1 is 5. I'm assuming it as 5. Random. Is that okay? Hello. Hello. Yes. Is that okay?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Now next, num2.
And we have num2. So again, we have write math.random.
So shall I take it as 3? Some random number 3 I will get?
Yes,
is that
sir.
Okay? Okay. Then what will happen?
And we have a print statement.
What does the print statement say?
What is the sum of num1 and num2?
So it will give us the output as what is the sum of 5 and 3. It'll ask us like this, right? It'll ask us a question. So when it asks us a question, okay, as a programmer, we have to actually assume that you are teaching, you're taking tuitions for maths. Okay, and you are actually teaching some, first standard kid, mathematics. Is that okay, Shruti? So
okay,
you want to test whether that kid knows addition, right? So you will write a program and you will ask that kid, okay, what is the sum of 5 and 3? And now that kid will say, 8, assume. Is that okay? Or else we'll take wrong number. Initially, we'll take wrong number, okay? So assume that the kid will enter 10 through the keyboard. Okay, so if I'm entering 10 through the keyboard, that how do you take 10 through the keyboard? Tell me, do you need a scanner class for that, guys?
Yes, sir.
Don't we need a scanner class when you are entering some value? Yes or no, everyone? Yes or no? Even if the kid has to enter the answer, we need some, we have to take the input. So see in the next page, I'm taking it. Am I taking that? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Scanner class.
Yeah, scanner class is there. So this, when I enter through the keyboard 10, where will it go and sit? Tell me, where will it go and sit?
In answer.
In answer, exactly. In the variable named answer, it will go and sit, isn't it? Very good. Okay, next what I'm having, what is there?
Next we have a while loop.
There is a while loop, isn't it, guys? There is a while loop. Did you see that? Okay, then what happens in while loop, ma? Did you see that?
We have there? A condition. Yeah,
we have a Boolean expression. Did you see that? We have a Boolean expression.
Boolean expression.
So yes, sir. The num1 plus num2 will happen first because it is within brackets, correct? No? So what is
yes,
num1?
Sir. 5.
No, plus?
3.
Okay, 3. Okay, and then?
If
okay. So it is, will become what? While, see, I'm writing it here. While, okay, it becomes 5 not equal to, what is answer that we have given? What that kid has given?
Sir, num1 plus num2, sir.
Ah, num, sorry. What is num1 plus num2? 8, no? Sorry.
8,
okay.
Sir.
Okay. So num1 plus num2 is 8. So 8. And what is the answer that kid has given?
10.
10. So now tell me what will happen to this condition? 8 not equal to 10.
It becomes
true or false?
True, sir.
True. 8 is not equal to 10. Therefore, it is true, no? If it
yes,
is
sir.
True, what will happen? I'll enter into that while loop. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
So when I enter into that loop, what will happen? What is written over there?
The first statement is, we have a print statement which is wrong answer, try again.
Yeah, so it will say if both are not same, wrong answer, try again. And I'm giving one more system.out.println. Again, I'll ask, what is the sum of num1 and num2? Same thing will repeat. What is the sum of 5 and 3? It means your kid, your tuition kid, okay? So that tuition kid, what happened? You know, he when you said, what is the sum of 5 and 3? He entered 10. Okay, then inside
yes,
the loop will check whether it is correct or not. If it is not correct, no, but it will enter into that loop and it will again ask, what is the sum of? Same thing. Again, it is asking, what is the sum of 5 and 3?
5 and 3.
Did you see that output over there? I have given the output also, right? And then what happens inside the while loop? You are asking for an input. Correct, no?
Did you yes, see sir.
While loop? Again, you are asking for an input, correct?
Yeah. So then yes, sir.
Again, assume that you have entered some wrong number, say 11. The kid has entered 11. So then what will happen? Tell me. Again, it will go to the while loop, correct?
While loop, yes, sir.
Guys, yes or no? It goes to the while header. The while loop will be running until the condition will become true. Until the condition becomes false. Once the condition becomes false, only the control will come out of the while loop. Yes or no, guys? Guys,
yes,
are you
sir.
Understanding? Yeah? Now, if the kid has entered 11, what will happen? While, it go to the while 5 plus 3, which is nothing but 8, not equal to 11. Is it true?
Yes, sir.
True. Again, it will enter. And what will it say? Wrong answer, try again. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Then it will say, what is the sum of? Again, it will say, what is the sum of? Okay, 5 and 3. Now you will enter again, wrong answer. We'll enter again, wrong answer. Okay. Say, what is the sum? It will, same thing will repeat. What is the sum of 5 and 3? Okay, 5 and 3. You'll enter like this. Okay. And now you'll enter, say, 12. Now in that case, what will happen?
Will again enter into the loop, sir.
Num1 plus num2, 8 not equal to 12. Okay, it is true. It will get into it. Again, it will say wrong answer, try again. Okay, now this time we will type the correct answer. Is that okay? Okay, this
yes,
time
sir.
We will say, so how much is it? 8. Okay, so now when we enter 8, will it go to the while header?
No, sir.
It will go to the while header.
It will go to the while header.
It will
but
say
it will
5
not.
Plus 3 is nothing but 8 not equal to 8. Okay. And then what happens? 8 not equal to 8 is false.
False.
So while will become false and it will come out of the while loop. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Guys, did you understand this? How while is working actually? Did you understand how while is actually working? I think you will get an idea now how we can use while, okay, to do something again and again. Now I've given you the output, just see that, okay. So the sample run I've given, okay, Java addition quiz, what is the sum of 5 and 1? Immediately, if suppose you say 6, it will say yes, you are right, and it will keep quiet. Correct? No, it will not enter into the while loop. But if you say wrong answer, it will be getting into the while loop again and again. Guys, did you understand this? Everyone? Hello, guys, yes or no? Did you understand this or not? Quickly. Hello, everyone. I'm waiting for you. You have any doubts, ask me quickly. You have any doubts in this problem, ask me. I think you cannot have any doubt because you have done it in detail. Shruti, you have any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Absolutely no.
Pakka. No, sir.
Guaranteed.
Yes, sir.
Okay, wait, don't run away.
Hello, sir.
Hello, tell me.
Sir, Arun here.
Yeah.
Arun. Sir, in the while loop, to take input from the keyboard, there is no scanner in... class. Scanner class is not there in the loop. How can we take that?
Scanner class is already
like
defined.
After
no?
the
scanner class is already defined on the top.
Okay.
No, only once you can do that is enough.
Okay, sir. Okay.
It is defined, no, on the top. Scanner class is there.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and I can use this method any number of times.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Once I start with object-oriented thinking, you'll understand how to do. Don't worry. Okay?
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah, fine. Guys, everyone, I'm waiting. Is that okay? I'll move on now. I'm moving to the next one. Sure? Yeah, okay. I'll not explain this again, once again, all the concepts. Is that okay? Yeah, okay. Now, third one is your assignment. Write down third one. Yeah, who is this? Who is this? Hello?
Sir, it's Pratibha.
It is Pratibha.
Hello.
Hello, tell me, who is this?
Pratiksha, sir.
Yeah, Pratiksha, tell me.
Sir, it's Pratiksha.
Huh, what
sir, in this? Both the program you used scanner class. But you not use that import statement.
Okay.
Then how you got sir output?
I used it, but I did not put it in the material. It is assumed whenever you are using scanner class, you have to put import statement. I am not putting that everywhere. Is that okay?
Okay.
See, it is assumed that it is there. I am not writing import statement everywhere. This is to only explain the concepts only. I am not putting import.java.util everywhere. You are understanding?
Yes, sir.
Pratiksha, did you understand? Right?
Yes,
so whenever
sir.
It is needed, you have to put yourself. I am not putting it in any of the program. This program is only to explain you the while loop and for loop. Okay, ma?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Chalo. Guys, throughout the course, if I have not put any import statement, assume that you have to put. It is not mandatory that I have to put anything. That if suppose I'm coming up with a new import statement, that I will put. Okay, for scanner and all, you guys know that you have to put for that. You know, you'll have to use import statement, right? Java.util. Okay. Is it mandatory that I have to put in every program? Not required. No. If I'm actually introducing any new import statement, that I will show it to you. Okay. No, my concentration is not on import statement. My concentration is on the loops. Is that okay, guys? You have to put import statement. Okay. So whenever I have not put, it means that you have to do it by yourself. Okay. Yeah. It is understood. Okay, Pratiksha. Right. So the third one, take it as your assignment to print multiplication table from 1 to 10. Okay. It will demonstrate how to use nested loops. Is that okay, guys? Nested loops. Hello. Okay. Shall we do one small nested loop? And this I'll give you as assignment. Shruti, you are there?
Yes, sir.
Shruti, tell me the output for this. For I is equal to 0. Okay. I less than 2. Okay. And I plus plus. I plus plus. Okay, and then open the brace and close the brace, right? Then I'd say for, okay, j is equal to 0, j less than 2, j plus plus, okay, open the brace and close brace. Here I will say system.out.println Shruti, okay, Shruti, I'll say like this, and inside I'll say system.out.println. Who is your favorite hero, Shruti?
Sudeep.
Sudeep, Kicha. Kicha fan, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me the output of this now.
Shruti will get printed.
Hey, first you navigate.
First, I is 0.
Guys, first of all, this is nested loop, okay? A loop inside a loop. A loop within a loop is called as nested loop. Okay, now tell me.
I is equal to 0.
Okay.
And 0 is less than 2.
True.
Then Shruti will get printed.
Okay, go to I plus plus.
No, sir.
No, very good. Okay. The control will come into the loop. Okay. Then.
Shruti will get printed. And.
Shruti will get printed. Okay. Let me write it. Shruti will get printed. Okay. Then.
I plus plus.
Hey, who is this? Sorry, Shruti. It will go to I plus plus, huh?
Or will it go? I am not sure, sir. Will it go to sure. Next?
See, listen, this entire thing will belong to this for loop. Okay?
Okay.
So it has to execute this entire thing. This is inner loop. This is outer loop. This is outer loop. And this is inner loop. Okay? This is
sir.
Outer loop and this is inner loop. Is that okay? So this inner loop belongs to the outer loop. So if for loop, okay. So now listen, okay, let me give you this, I'll give you one more example. Listen to me carefully. Okay.
Okay,
what if I have for I is equal to 0 semicolon I less than 2 semicolon I plus plus. Okay. Open the brace and close brace. Within this, I have system dot out dot println Sudeep. Who is your second hero? Quickly, tell me.
No second hero, sir.
Hey, keep one second hero. Yeah, we'll keep Yash. Okay. Keep one second hero. If this fellow goes, you become swap, you use this fellow. I mean, you start liking his movies. Okay. Now listen to me, right? Now, if now tell me what is the output of this? Tell me. For I is equal to 0, 0 less than true 2, it is true or false, Suti?
It's true, sir.
It is true. I'll enter. Now, what will happen? What will be the output? It will run both the executable statement now?
Yes, sir.
It will print Sudeep and Yash, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
At one run, when it runs for the first time, it will run both Sudeep and Yash, correct? No? Similar.
Yes, sir.
This for loop and the system dot 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 println both belongs to for loop only. So once I enter into the loop, both has to be executed.
Okay, sir.
Only then I can go to I plus plus. Once this is complete, only I can go to I plus plus. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Did you understand this? Right?
Yes, sir.
So now tell me the output of this now quickly.
I is equal to 0. Then okay. 0 is. Okay. Then Shruti
gets. Shruti gets printed. Okay, then. Shruti
then we'll have.
There. Okay, then.
We'll have to enter into the next for loop.
Exactly. Then j is equal to 0.
0. J is less than 2.
Hmm.
And it'll enter into the loop. For loop. Ah. Then Sudeep will get printed.
Sudeep will get printed then.
Is it j plus plus?
It is j plus plus because I cannot go to I plus plus until this for loop is complete. This for loop belongs to this for loop. No, it has to complete. Only then I can go to I plus plus. Until this is complete, I cannot go here. See, this for loop belongs to this outer for loop.
Yes, sir. Okay,
this inner for loop belongs to outer for loop. So both has to get executed completely. Only then I can go to I plus plus. Guys, did you understand this? Yes or no? Hello, everyone. Did you understand this? Right now it goes to
okay,
J.
Sir.
Tell me what is J value now?
Now J value becomes 1.
One. Then 1 less than 2.
Less than 2. Again, Sudeep will get printed.
Exactly. Again, Sudeep will get printed. Okay. Then again, Sudeep will get printed. Then
J value becomes 2.
J value will become 2. Okay. Then, huh.
2 less than 2 is false. 2 is false. Then we'll have
it will come out of the for loop.
Yes,
so when
sir.
It comes out of the for loop, what happens? Okay. So
I plus.
I plus plus. So plus. This is over. So I'll go to I plus plus. Now I value will become what?
One.
I value will become 1. So 1 less than 2?
It's true, sir.
It'll
enter into the loop.
Huh.
Shruti will get printed.
Okay. Then for loop will again start from first.
Yes.
I will start.
From here, from J, sir?
J is equal to 0. This is done. See, first I is equal to 0, I less than 2, entered. So Shruti will get printed. And then this for loop will get executed. J is equal to 0, J less than 2, entered. Sudeep, J plus plus, J less than 2, Sudeep. Then again, this got over, came out. And then I plus plus. For the second time, for loop is running. Then again, I plus 2, I less than 2. That is 1 less than 2, true. Now again, this is fresh. This is the fresh run. Fresh iteration.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then Shruti will get it printed. Then what will happen? Again, this will start fresh. J is equal to 0. Correct?
Yes, sir. And 0 is less than 2.
0 is less than 2. Then what happens?
Sudeep gets printed.
Sudeep gets printed. Okay. Sudeep gets printed. Then what will happen? J plus plus. J value,
Will
become 1. 1 less than 2 is 2. Okay.
1 is less than 2 and again will enter to the loop.
Okay. Then what happens? J plus plus. J value will become 2. 2 less than 2 becomes false.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then what happens?
I plus plus.
It will come out of this for loop and then I plus plus. I value becomes how much? 2, no?
2, yes, sir.
2 less than 2 is false. Then it will come out of the outer for loop also. So the output is Shruti, Sudeep, Sudeep, Shruti, Sudeep, Sudeep. Is that okay?
Yes. Okay, sir.
Thanks, Naveen. Yeah. So did you get this? Guys, did you understand inner for loop? Inner loops, nested loops. These are nested. This loop is nested within this loop. Did you guys understand? Yes or no? Hello? Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Clear? Shruti, don't run away. Be there.
Okay, sir.
Guys, did you understand everyone? Easy, no? Easy one. Everyone? Yeah? Any doubts, ask me quickly. I'm waiting.
Sir, for the J value, we have to consider the I value itself, sir.
For J value, you have to consider I value means what is the question?
Sir, from where do we get the value of J, sir?
Where do we get the value of J, yeah? J,
yes,
we are
sir,
J. No, J is equal to 0.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Huh?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Guys, any doubt? Guys, hello. Any doubt? Shall we proceed? Shall I proceed? Guys, shall I proceed? Okay, cool. Now, third one, will you solve by yourself? I've given the output. Can you navigate like this, third one? Can you navigate? Not can you, you have to. Shruti, will you navigate?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Not now. After the class, you have to do it by yourself. I've given you the output. 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3, 1 4s are 4. I've given you detailedly. So like how me and Shruti navigated first two programs, you have to navigate that. Is that okay? Guys, hello? Okay or not? Yeah, okay, cool. Now, so there are three more programs down, that is, you know, write a program that we will do later. So we'll all first finish up all the theory concepts. Is that okay, guys? Shall we finish all the theory concepts and then go ahead? Yeah, okay, cool. Okay, now, shall we continue guys? Okay, shall we continue?
Yes,
sir. Continue means not this continue, class continue. Continue means a continue concept is there. Continue concept. Okay, did you see that? You thought I'm continuing, I'm asking you to continue the class, huh? Shruti, you thought that only, no?
No, sir.
No? Okay, right. Continue, now listen to me. Continue means, shall we continue means, shall we learn the concept, continue. Now listen to me carefully. Continue is a keyword which is used to continue the loops. Can you please put that in the chat box? Okay, so Shruti, repeat along with me. What is it? Why is continue used?
It is used to continue the loops.
Can you please underline that line which is there in page number 35? Underline that. Shall we continue? I mean, not that one, the next one. Continue is used to continue the loops. Can you please underline and then say underlined? After underlining, say underlined. Continue is used to continue the loops. Say underlined. Did you underline? Very important. Continue cannot be used with anything else other than loops. Continue can be used only within loops. Write it down. Write it down in your material. Continue can be used only within loops. It cannot be used with anything else. Continue can be used only within loops. Write down in that material quickly. Write down. Okay. Now. Okay. So Shruti, shall we navigate? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Guys, are you all ready? Shall we navigate? Are you all ready? I'm navigating through the programs now. Hello, guys. Ready? Yeah. Fine. Start, Shruti.
Public class continuing. The class name is continuing.
Class name is continuing. Okay.
And public static void main.
Okay.
And we have a variable I of data type integer.
Beautiful, very good. Then?
And we have a for loop.
Okay.
I is equal to 0.
Okay.
And I is less than 10 and I one plus minute, plus.
Is 0 less than 10?
Yes, sir.
So should I enter into that loop?
In if loop, we have a statement next.
Yeah, so should we enter into that loop, yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, I'll enter into the loop. Then what is there?
I equal
conditional
equal
statement
to...
is there, correct?
Yes, sir.
So tell that conditional statements. If
I equal to 1.
Is I equal to equal to 1? Put that in the chat box, guys. Is I equal to equal to 1? False. It will result in false. Okay, then. Tell me next. Or
I equal to 3.
Is I equal to 3, guys? Tell me. False. Therefore, false or with false. Then.
I equal to 6.
Is I equal to 6, guys? False. Therefore, result in false. So tell me this entire thing will result in what? False or with false will give you what? False.
False.
Or with false will give you false. Okay. That or with false will give you how much? False.
False.
The if condition became what? What does the condition, Boolean expression for if condition, what did it result in? This resulted in false. Isn't it? Yes, yes or no? So if it is false, will it enter into that if block?
No, sir.
Not. So continue belongs to the if block, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So it will not enter. So will it enter into the else block?
No, sir.
No.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It will enter into the else block, else isn't block. It? If
yes,
it falls, it will ignore this. It will enter into the else block.
Else.
So what is there in system.out.println?
Print I.
So what will get printed?
Zero.
Zero will get printed. Okay. Then what will happen?
I value will become 1.
Exactly. Now I value will become 1. What is I value?
From 0 will become to 1. Huh. And 1 will, it will enter into the loop. And the condition.
No. Tell me 1 less than 10. No.
So 1 is less than 10.
So it is true. So true. I enter into that loop. Okay. Then.
Then 1 equal to 1.
Is y equal to 1?
True, sir.
True, no? So yes, I don't need to actually check other conditions, but anyway, still I equal to equal to 3?
No, sir, false.
Or with I equal to equal to 6?
False.
Okay, true or with false is how much?
True.
True. True or with false again, how much?
True.
False. Sorry, true. Therefore, the entire expression will become how much?
True, sir.
True. When I say true, so will it enter into the if condition?
Yes, sir.
When it enter the if condition, what is the statement given over here?
Continue.
The moment it says continue, the control will not go further. Rather, it will go to I++. Okay, it will go to I++. It is saying continue the loop. Don't go further. Don't run any other statements. Run the go to I++. The moment I say continue, it means go to I++. Is that okay? Does you understand this? Continue means continue the loop. Don't go further. Go to I++. Just continue the loop. Don't do anything else now. Continue is used to continue the loops. Now what will happen?
I value becomes 2.
I value becomes 2. Correct. Then what happens?
2 is less than 10.
Yeah. Then what happens?
It'll enter into the loop.
Then what happens?
2 is equal to equal to, I mean, I is equal to equal to 1, false.
Okay.
I equal to 3 is also false.
Okay.
I equal to 6 is false.
Okay.
And
so the entire thing becomes false. Will it enter into the condition?
No, sir.
It will come to the else part. In the else part, it will print the value of I. So what is I value?
2.
2, correct? So earlier it was 0, 2, it did not print 1. Okay, now when it was 1, it became continue. So similarly, tell me guys, what will be the output of this program if you keep running the code for 10 times, what will get printed? Okay, so other than whatever is there inside this, right? No, okay, if I value is equal to 1, or if it is equal to 3, or if it is equal to 6, okay, then it will continue. It means it will not print 1, 3, and 6. Other than that, it will print all the values from 0 to 9. Isn't it, guys? It will print from 0 to 9 except 1, 3, and 6. Yes or no? Except 1, 3, and 6, it will print all the values. Correct, no, guys? Hello? Shruti, yes or no? Shruti?
Yes, sir.
Shruti,
yes,
correct, sir. No? Did you understand, Shruti?
Yes, sir.
Correct, guys, everyone? Yes or no? It will print all the values except 1, 3, and 6. Isn't it? Yes or no? Everyone, put that in the chat box. Did everyone understand? Hello? Did everyone understand? Yes or no? Any doubts? Ask
me. Sir.
Any doubts? Ask me quickly. Any doubts? Ask me quickly.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, generally, if we have an if else statement, if the if condition is true, it will, however, not go to else. No, sir. Then why do we need continue?
No, this here it is not there. Okay, but certain stages here for see continue is not part of if. Continue is not part of it. Yes, continue, sir, is part of the loop. Okay. So this program is given just to explain you how continue will work. This is a simple dummy program to explain you how continue will work. Okay. No. So okay, certain sir. Times there are scenarios when you don't want to continue further when a certain condition is met. Okay. No. In that case, you'll have to continue. This don't consider this as a very real program and all that. This program is just to explain you continue. You getting what I'm saying?
Okay, sir.
You understand what I'm saying? Yes. So what I'm trying to tell you is continue is not part of, I mean, does not belong to if. I mean, continue is not used with if. Continue is used for loops. Okay. But if suppose you want
to continue. It's part of the loop, yeah.
It's part of the loop, correct? No, continue can be used only within loops, yeah. Right? Just because this continue is used within if doesn't mean that, you know, I mean, I understood your question. Okay. But it is not because some, you know, if condition doesn't mean it will not go to else and all that. Okay. So my question, if suppose, say, for example, there might be scenarios where if condition matches. Okay. Okay. Let me explain this to you. Take some time and explain to you. If suppose say if condition matches, who is this? First of all, who is this talking?
Sir, Mohammed Ashwak, sir.
Okay. Ashwak, assume that there is a condition like this. Okay. If condition and else condition. Is that okay? Right. And then okay, we have a certain set of statements. Correct.
Okay.
And then here I will put continue. Or if suppose I have not put continue. Okay. And I have something like system.out.println or something like that. Okay, and then say hello or something like that. Okay, now in this case, tell me if this value is true. Okay, if this condition Boolean expression resulted in true, and then it will print, does it go to else part?
No, sir, it won't.
So it will print hello, isn't it? And then after printing hello, yes, don't you think these statements will get executed?
Yes, sir, out of the if block, that is else block.
Exactly, out of the entire else if, I mean if else, correct? It will print value out of if else, right? So what if I don't want these statements?
Okay, so you put continue there, it will not even execute those statements.
Yeah, when I say continue, it will directly go to I++ of the for loop or while loops. While loops continue. Continue okay, can also okay, be used okay. with while loop also. So it will automatically go to the header, either for header or while header. It will not even execute these statements.
Sir, only if there is a situation to get into else, this statement will be printed, the out of the
yeah,
block.
Yeah, if suppose this is continue and if suppose say this becomes false. If this becomes false, it doesn't enter into this if block, okay? And it comes to else part. Yeah. If it comes to else part, even this will get executed.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, fine. Okay. Guys, shall we go ahead?
Sir, Dhyanesh here. Not doubt, sir, but I just want to clarify something. Sir, so the continue will be related to the nearest for loop, no, sir? If it's in
exactly. Wait till the... Give me a moment. Wait till... I think you must wait till next page. Wait till next page. Okay, come to that.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Give me just 2-3 minutes. That's all. We'll come to that. Okay, Dhyanesh?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, cool. Guys, I'll continue till the next page and then I think your doubts will be cleared. Is that okay? Give me time till there. Most of your doubts will be cleared. Did you understand this concept, guys? Tell me that first. Did you understand this concept, guys? Okay. Once I go to the next page, I think most of your doubts will be, clarified. Is that okay? Did you understand this continue? Continue is used to continue without proceeding further with the loops. Is that okay with the statements? Is that okay? Suppose say Ashwak asked for I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus. Okay. And open the brace and close brace. If these statements were part of this for loop and if condition became true over here and if there was a statement in if block, these statements will not get executed. It will just continue with I plus plus. Yes or no, guys? Did you understand what I'm saying? It will go to I++ and then continue. Yes or no, guys? Hello? Did you understand this? Hello? Everyone? Okay, cool. Right. Now, let me take the next one. Okay. Now, so, Shruti, you're there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, one is continue. The other one is break. Okay? Break is used to break out of the loop. Break is used to, put that in the chat. What is that, Shruti? Break is used to?
Break is used to break out of the loops.
Or it can also be used with switch that we have already discussed. Okay, which can we can also break out of the loops, isn't it? Now, can you please explain that what happens there, Shruti?
We have a public class breaking.
Okay.
And public static void main.
Okay.
And we have a variable I of integer data type. Okay. And we have a for loop. I is equal to 0.
Okay.
I less than 10, which is true.
Oh, 0 less than 10 is true, correct then.
It'll enter into the loop.
Okay, then?
0 equal to 1 is false.
Okay, false or with?
0 equal to 3 is also false.
For or with?
0 equal to 6 is false.
False or with? Okay.
And the if statement becomes false,
okay.
So again, I++, sorry, I mean else. Sorry,
else is there. Okay, then
I value gets printed.
Sorry, it's break. No, sorry, it's break. Okay, it's break.
Sir,
okay. I value will get printed, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so what is I value? 0 will get printed.
0.
Okay, then
I++,
then it goes to I++ in the for loop. Okay, then
I value become 1.
Okay,
1 is less than 10.
Hmm.
It'll enter into the if header.
For loop, it will enter. Once it enters into the for loop, then you will get a if conditional statement. Then
1 is equal to 1 is true.
It is true, isn't it? It is true. Anyways, it will not check the other condition, but we'll just check it off. Okay, then
or with 1 equal to 3 is false.
So this entire thing will become true, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if it is true, what happens? I'll enter the if block. Then what is there?
Break.
The moment I break, what happens? It will come out of the for loop. That's all. End of for loop. And only 0 will get printed. That's all.
Sir, is it end of for or end of if, sir?
No, break is used for loops. It is breaking out of the loop. It can be used only with loops or switch, not for if.
Okay.
It is used inside if, doesn't mean it belongs to if, actually. Break is used to break out of the loops when certain conditions are met.
Okay, sir.
If I is equal to 1, then I'm just saying it to break. So it will break out of the loop. Is that okay? So the output is only zero. Guys, is that okay? Hello? Hello? Is that okay? Guys, hello, did you understand this? It'll just break out of the loop. That's all.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Hello? Hello? Someone spoke to me now, no?
Sir, you told to say okay, so I said okay, sir.
Okay, chalo, fine. Okay, so Shruti?
Yes, sir.
Shall we go to the next one?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, tell me what is the next one.
Another encounter with continue.
Exactly, another encounter with continue. Okay, no? Right? Yeah, so guys, I'm going to the next one. Are you all ready? No? You're there now with me? Another 15-20 minutes we'll do, because we missed the first 15-20 minutes. No, we'll just extend that. Okay? Right? One day, or one day. Because of this internet problem, I'm really sorry. But luckily, we got back our internet. Is that okay? Yeah. So, I don't like missing the sessions. Yeah? Fine? Yeah. Okay. Tell me, ma, another encounter with continue. Okay. What is the heading? Underline that. Continue without a label. Underline that, everyone. After underlining, say underlined. Continue without a label. Continue without a label. Underline that. Underline that. Continue without a label and say underlined. Did you underline? Very good. Okay, after underlining. Then tell me. Continue, ma. Continue.
We have public class continuing.
Hmm.
And public static void main.
Okay.
And we have two variables, I and j. Hmm. Of data type int.
Okay.
We have a for loop.
Not for one for loop. We have two for loops. That is nested for loops. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
We have nested for loops. Then tell me.
For I is equal to 0.
I is equal to 0. Okay.
I less than 5.
Hmm.
It'll enter. I less than 5 is true.
Okay. Wait. Let me write that. Okay. Let me write it on the screen. Okay, for I is equal to 0, then I less than 5,
less than.
Okay, then I plus plus, open the brace, close the brace, then I have for, okay, j is equal to 0, okay, j less than 5, semicolon.
Less than or equal to 5, sir.
Then less than or equal to 5, okay, open the brace and close brace. Within this, I have if, what is that, ma? J is equal to, J equal to 3 or with J equal to 4. Then I have to do continue.
Continue. Yes.
Else. I have to say system.out.println J. I will say. Okay. And then I have, as part of that only, I have, what is that? It's outside the for loop. Okay. Then I have to say outside this, both the for loops I have. Oh, just a new line. That's all. println. Okay. Right. Now tell me what will happen from first.
I is equal to 0.
Hmm. Quickly, you must say. I is equal to 0, then.
0 is less than 5 is true.
Okay.
It'll enter into the next for loop.
Hmm.
J is equal to...
It'll enter into this for loop, that is outer for loop. Then I will find one inner loop.
Yes, sir.
And
it'll, and J is less than 0. Which is,
J is equal to 0.
J is equal to 0. 0 is less than or equal to 5.
True. I'll enter into this for loop. Okay, then...
And we have a if condition.
Tell me.
J equal to 1.
False, huh?
It's false.
Okay, or with?
Or with, the whole thing will be false. Sir.
Whole thing. Hey, you repeat now. Why you are saying continue? Say J equal to 3. Lazy, you are lazy girl. Tell completely.
No, J equal to 3 is false. Or with J equal to 4 is false.
So false, or with false, with for will become false. So will it enter into this if condition?
No, sir. We'll enter into the else state.
So what will get printed?
J will get printed.
What is J value?
0.
0. Then what? Where will it go?
The outer for loop.
To get to I++ first, this for loop has to get completed, no? I discussed no earlier. First, we have to complete this for loop. Only then I can go to I++,
yes,
no?
Sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
Hey, Shruti, what happened? 9:30, you are full this thing? You are feeling sleepy?
No, sir.
Then where it will go? It will go to J++ now. No, first to get into I++ first, this for loop has to complete.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me what will happen.
Now J value becomes 1.
Then
1 is less than or equal to 5 is true. It'll enter into if J equal to 1, which is true.
True. Okay. So when if it is true, I'll enter into if condition, correct?
Yes, sir.
When I say then what is there?
Continue.
Where it will go? It will go to I++ or J++? If I say continue, will it go to inner J++ or outer J++? It will always go to the inner one. It will match the J++. This is what, Dhyanesh, this is what you asked me. Dhyanesh, you asked this one.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So this continue belongs to the inner, nearest to for loop. So it becomes J++. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Yeah, fine. Then J value will become what? 2, no?
2, sir.
2 less than or equal to 5 then?
2 less than or equal to 5 is true. Then we have if
condition
false.
The else part, then we'll print 2, correct?
2.
Then
yes, sir.
Go to J++ once again. J value will become 3. 3 less than or equal to 5 is true. It will come inside. Then this will become true. Then we'll continue. Then again J++. J will become 4. 4 less than or equal to 5 is true. It will come here. This is false. Then it will come to else part. Then it will print 4. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Then J value will become what? 5, huh? 5. 5 less than or equal to 5 is true. I'll enter
true.
Into this. So it will come, then it will print what? So is equal to 1, equal to nothing, it is not there. So it will print 0, 2, 4, 5. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Then once this is over, then I++ will happen. Correct, no? Once our inner for loop is over, then only I will come to I++. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Because J++ became 6. 6 less than or equal to 5 is false. It will come out of the inner for loop. Outer for loop is alive. Then I will start with I++. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
I value will now become how much?
1.
1. 1 less than 5 is true.
Yes, sir.
I'll enter into this for loop. So I'll get one again, new for loop, fresh for loop.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. 4 will not get printed. Sorry. 4 will not get printed. Okay. It is 4 is equal continue. No. Yeah. So what is there? 0 to what will get printed, guys? 0 to and 5. 0 to 5 will get printed. Okay. Right. All right. Then again, I++, I value will become 1. 1 less than 5. I will enter into this. Then J is equal to 0. Again, it will start from 0. Correct. No. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this will continue. So what I want to explain in this program is that when you say continue inside an inner for loop, this continue will actually, okay, belongs, I mean, the moment when I say continue, it will continue the inner for loop and not the outer for loop. Guys, did you understand this? Everyone, do you understand this? Let me run the code. Okay, let me see if the code is there. Let me run this code. Okay, so vi continue with label. Oh, sorry, continue without label. Continue without label. Okay, no. So is this the same program? Guys, is this the same program? Is this the same program, guys? Hello? Yes or no? Okay, right. Shall I run the code? What is the output that you're expecting? Tell me. What is the output that you're expecting, guys? Tell me so that I can cross-verify later. Tell me what is the output that you're expecting? Okay,
zero,
with the 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 5, 5 times, isn't it? Okay. Yeah. Okay. Let me try this. Is that okay? Everyone okay? Yeah. Okay. Right. So Java C continue without label.java. Java continue without label. Okay. So 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 5. Is that okay, guys? Guys, is that okay? Hello?
Okay, sir.
Is that okay? You understand this? Okay,
sir.
So what is that I wanted to tell you? Tell me, what is the moral of this program? Not moral of the story, moral of this program, what was it?
That continue belongs to the
exactly.
Inner.
So when you have nested for loops and the continue will actually, you know, will continue the innermost for loop. Is that okay? Right. So the next question is that what if I want to continue from the outer for loop? I want to write continue here, but I want to continue from the I++. Here continue is actually, you know, belonging to J. I mean, it's continuing J++, isn't it? Now, what if this continue has to continue from I++, even though I write this continue inside the inner for loop, okay? In that, I have to put a label. See the next concept. That is basically the label. Did you see continue, Subhash? Guys, did you see that continue? And one, there is one label called as Subhash. Did you see that, guys? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Called as a continue with label. This is not available in C language. It is available. It is, you know, only for Java. Continue, Subhash. And did you see where is that I placed the label, guys? Where did I place the label? Where did I place the label, guys? Hello? Where did I place the label? See there? Okay. Outside the outer for loop. Did you see that? Outside of out of the loop. That is outer for loop. Before the first for loop. Correct, Nikita? Correct. Before the first for loop. Did you see that, Subhash? So when I put a label over there and then say continue, Subhash, it will not continue from J++. It will continue from I++. Did you understand, guys? Guys, did you understand? Yes or no? Did you understand that? Hello? Yes or no? Did you understand that? Everyone? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, The same thing with break also. Same thing with break. Come to another encounter with break. Okay. So what will break do? Shruti, tell me, what will break do?
It will break out of the loop.
Once again, Anu is asking for repeat, sir. Okay. Anu, can you unmute yourself and talk to me? Anu, can you unmute yourself and talk to me quickly? It's really okay. Anyways, see, continue is used to continue within inner loop. If suppose you want this continue to continue from outer loop, then you put a label here. You tell the continue that start from here, Subhash, or any label, and you say from where to continue. Okay, continue, Subhash. That's all. Okay, now continue. Okay, now tell me the break. Yeah, what is break used for?
It is used to break out of the loop.
It is break out of the loop. What if the break is given inside a inner loop? You have for loop, okay, and then inside this you have a for loop, okay, and then I put a break over here. It will break out of which loop? Tell me.
The outer.
Which loop? Hey, no, it will break out from the inner loop. Shruti. Shruti.
Sir, in switch statement, like if he is...
Yeah, forget switch, yeah. Who is talking about switch now?
Okay, sir.
In switch also, what switch? Tell switch, what switch?
It will come out of the switch, the whole loop, no, sir.
This is not loop, it is switch statement. Is this a loop?
No, sir.
Is this a loop, yeah, Shruti? Tell me.
No, sir.
Hello, if I break, what will happen? It will break out of the switch. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Then tell.
If there is case 2, it will not enter into case 2, no, sir.
It will not enter into case 2. Okay, fine. What is there now?
So I thought it's the same here.
What same? It has, this has nothing to do with for. How can this be same? Switch is not at all a loop.
Okay, sir.
Here, see, it's very simple. It's very, very simple. I explained, you know. So, okay. Generally, the previous example we discussed, what was there? You had a for loop. Okay, and once the for loop was there, we had a break here. Okay, so break means what will happen? It will break out of this for loop, correct? No,
okay, sir.
Okay, so I wanted to now introduce something new. For that, I put one more for loop inside this, one more for loop I put, correct? No, yes, or
yes,
no?
Sir.
Inside this for loop, okay, inside this for loop, I put a break. So my question was, break will break out, I mean, which will end this for loop or outer for loop?
Inner for loop.
Yeah, so it will break out of this inner for loop and continue with this for loop. Yes or no?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so we will navigate through that. Okay. Guys, are you feeling... shall I continue the class tomorrow? I think you guys are exhausted. You want me to continue or we'll do it tomorrow? Guys, you want me to do... Because I don't know. What do you feel? Continue?
We will finish the... We'll finish the break thing, sir.
We'll finish the break, guys. Guys, give little bit of time. We will finish off just hardly 2-3 minutes. That's all. Hardly 2-3 minutes. Okay. And we'll finish break. Is that okay, guys? Okay. Yeah. Fine. Yeah. You know, execute that. Tell me what will happen there.
Break without label.
Break without label. Okay.
Public class name is breaking. And we have public static void main. We have two variables, I and J.
Okay.
And for I is equal to 0, I less than 5. 0 is less than 5, so it will enter into the loop. We have another for loop there. J is equal to 0, J less than or equal to 5. And it will enter into the loop. We have if statement. J, which is 0, equal to 1 is false.
One minute. Wait. J equal to 4. Okay. And then we have what? A break. Okay. Break.
Yes, sir.
And then else system.out.println and J. Correct? No? Okay. Tell me. I is equal to 0. I less than 5. True. I will enter into this loop. Okay. Then I'll have J is equal to 0. J less than or equal to 5. True. I'll enter into this loop. Okay. J equal to 1. So it is false. J equal to 3 is false. J is equal to false. So entire thing is false. Then I'll come to the else part. In the else part, I will print system.out.println. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So what is output? 0.
0.
Okay. And then what will happen? Again, J++. Correct? No?
Yes, sir.
Then J is less than or equal to 5. True? No?
Yes, sir. One is less than or equal to 5.
Yeah, I'll enter into this loop now.
Yes, sir.
So j equal to 1?
Yes, sir. True, sir.
It is true. If it is true, the entire thing will become true. Correct now?
Yes, sir.
So I'll enter into the if condition.
Yes, sir.
If I enter in if condition, what is there?
Break.
What will I do? Break out of this loop.
Inner loop.
Yeah, then outer for loop is alive. Correct now?
Yes, sir.
So I will not enter into this. I mean, this break is over. I'll come out of this and, you know, the outer for loop is alive. Then I'll go to I++. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now I value will become how much?
1.
So 1 is less than 5?
True.
I'll enter into this loop. Again, this loop will start for fresh. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So j is equal to 0. 0 less than or equal to 5. True. I'll enter into this. Now this condition will become false.
False.
Become else part. It'll print what? 0.
0.
Then again, I'll say j++. J value will become 1. 1 less than or equal to 5 is true. I'll enter into this. And then say j equal to 1 is true. Then this entire expression becomes true. I'll enter into break. Again, this inner for loop will break.
Yes, sir.
Then go to I++. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
3 less than 5 is true. Then the same thing continues for 5 times.
Yes, sir. Correct, 5 zeros. No? Yes, sir.
That's all. Can you see that break is there, guys, anywhere? I think a break I have not given, I think. Okay. I think, can you do this yourself, guys? It's not given. I have not. It is simple. Same as what is that? Continually. Continue will continue the loop. This will break the loop. Correct now, guys? Simple. Now, what if this break will break out of the inner for loop now, Shruti?
Yes, sir.
What if I want to break out of the outer for loop. Then what is that I have to do?
Label. We have to use
exactly, label. Shruti. Shruti is awesome. Exactly. So see the next program. I've given the label over there. Break from where? So I've given the label and I've said break Subhash. So I have given the label here, Subhash. Okay. And I'll tell break from where to break Subhash. Did you see that? So when I say break Subhash, so okay, from where should I break? From this label. Where is the label? Oh, from this for loop. So I will break out of the outer for loop. That's all. Is that okay?
Okay, sir.
Guys, is that okay? Hello, everyone. Is that okay, guys?
Yeah. Hello, this is Jagannath here.
Hi, Jagannath, tell me.
Yeah, so I have doubt here. So the label is just above the for loop, right? If you break the label, will the for loop still continues or?
What is that? Hello, Jagannath, I did not understand. What is that?
So the control goes to Subhash, right? To the label.
No, it's simple. When you say break Subhash, okay, break is asking from where should I break? From which loop? So I have given the label here. Any loop that you see from Subhash, no? Okay. Oh, is it? Now the break will think, oh, okay, this is the label. So label has a for loop over here. Okay. So it understands that I have to break out of this for loop and it will come out of this for loop.
So we have to mention the label.
One second. Jagannath, did I answer your question?
Yes. So I was just a bit confused with go to statement in C and the label here. So
Okay. Go to is not a breaking statement, right? Go to is a jumping statement.
Yes, but the labeling is the labeling concept.
Concept is same. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Someone was talking to me. Shruti, yourself?
Yes, sir. So we must mention the label before the loop. No, sir.
Exactly. Either Subhash you can write here or you can write here also. Subhash and colon. Colon is mandatory.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Guys, okay. Do one thing. As an assignment, write Subhash here and see what will happen. Guys, hello. Are you hearing me? As an assignment, write Subhash here. Okay. Write Subhash here. See all these things. Write Subhash different place and see what will happen. You'll only understand. Is that okay? Right? Yeah. Okay. So, okay. Guys, GUI programming I will do during the GUI chapter, but I'm not doing it now. Is that okay? GUI I will be doing when I'm doing GUI chapter. Is that okay, guys? Anything related to GUI? Now you might ask me, Subhash, when you're doing GUI chapter during the GUI, why have you written it over here? Yes or no? Ask me. Yes or no, guys? Ask me quickly. Yes or no? You have that question? Yeah. The question is that this GUI will make use of loops. This GUI will make use of loops. So therefore, after the course, when you're actually after the Java course, when you're revising the concepts, no? right? So you will know why I actually use it, because this GUI are making use of loops over here. That is the reason. Is that okay? But now I don't want to explain GUI because it requires classes and objects and all that. Is that okay, guys? So during your revision, you will understand why I actually gave GUI over here. Is that okay? See, in the GUI program, you will be using loops. Are you using loops? You're using loops over here, GUI program? Yeah, you're using continue, break and all that, right? So those concepts are related to this. That is why I just put it over here so that later when you're revising, you'll get to know. Okay. So shall we continue tomorrow, guys? Shall we continue tomorrow?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So thanks, Shruti. Thank you so much. So guys, meet you tomorrow and practice all the programs and then come to class. Okay. Chalo. Take care. Bye-bye. Good night.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
What doubt, ma?
Sir, I have doubt in operators, sir.
Operators are? What is the doubt?
Sir, as you said, for unary operator, right to left, I did the same, sir, but I got the wrong answer. Can you please explain? I will post in chat, sir.
Oh, do one thing. You can post it to me in my WhatsApp, to my number. I'll help you out, okay?
Sure, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, you post it to me. Do one thing. You follow this method. Okay, I'll give you, you message me personally. I'll tell you how to do, okay?
Hello? Sure, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah, I will send you one table, sir. Precedence table. You follow that, okay?
Sure, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, ma. Chalo. Bye.
Sir.
Hello?
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yeah, tell me.
Like, here we have used all in if conditions like short circuit operators, no, sir? But only if it will, if the first condition is true, the second also it will check, sir. I'm having doubt like that, sir.
It will not,
like you said,
if suppose there was in this case it will not check because everything was or operator only.
Okay only if I think in only if there are two conditions it will check.
It will not check. It depends on what is your expression.
Okay,
yeah. Okay,
thank you, sir.
Yeah, fine. Okay guys, practice all the programs before coming to tomorrow session. Okay.